it's not like you have a eureka moment or something. It's a very casual discussion kind of a story.
We actually began with this idea of making batteries which doesn't harm the environment at all.
I am Nishita Baliar Singh and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Nexus Power.
I am Nikita Baliar Singh and I'm the co-founder and COO of Nexus Power.
In the northern parts of India, the capital region of Delhi, the neighboring states, the air quality index was pretty bad. The reason why this actually happens is because the neighboring states around the capital city of Delhi in India, they harvest the crops and then they burn the remaining residue. And that's what causes this pollution. So that's where we kind of wanted to brainstorm and find out as to, is it possible that you don't burn it and you procure that part and maybe fix it somewhere in the battery?
All of this brings us together to make this product that we are working on, which is a biodegradable electric vehicle battery made out of crop residue. It was kind of challenging to take up something which we were not completely aware of. So to understand the terminologies, to have a grasp over what we were trying to do, we got ourselves enrolled to a lot of courses. I think the scope of research or the scope of experimenting on the battery components was restricted to the protein boundaries itself. So then we were not hunting for too much of these biodegradable material, but we were just focusing on different kinds of proteins. And in fact, we are still into a lot of R&D as well to reach even more efficient bonds. We did a lot of home experiments during the lockdown last year because of COVID. And the more you get into the technology, the more exciting it gets, just the way it happened for us. But eventually, when we kept researching on it, we realized that these batteries could charge faster. They have this tendency to maybe give a longer range than what the lithium-ion batteries do.
We are looking at least making it about 35-40% cheaper than the existing lithium-ion batteries. So yeah, it will be a drastic impact on the price as well. Before we go commercial, we'd also want to do large-scale pilots in a little, short-term. Milestones and the immediate milestones for the next 2-3 years. First is to get the battery out. Second is to have all our IP in place in terms of Indian patents, global patents, use the US patents that is required for the product to be in the market. And besides that, also look at a global launch.
We've been targeting to go commercial by 2022, sometimes around quarter four. So I think that we'll want to achieve that, and hopefully we will be able to.
Initially, we're just two of us. Trying to brainstorm and ideate, and today it's a good 20-member team, including both of us.
We still believe in having a lot of interactions, a lot of discussions with a lot of people. So the more we discuss, I think the more innovative we get. So that's what we believe in, that's what we want to continue doing as well.